Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Joe and welcome to a brand new video. And boy, we've got some talking to do. So the TF2 Twitter page, the official Twitter page, has just tweeted out update on the Great Depression of 2019. First of all, the fact they're referring to it as the Great Depression is just amazing to me. I don't know why. I just think it's fantastic that the Team Fortress 2 devs themselves are referring to this as the Great Depression. That's just amazing. Update on the Great Depression. So, they put out this lengthy blog post or news post, and we're going to get into it now. On the evening of Thursday, July 25th, a bug was introduced that allowed some older crates to grant an unusual hat on every opening. We fixed the bug the following morning and decided to trade lock hats from the bugged crates while we evaluated the situation. And that's where we've been for a good, almost a week now, I think, that everything's been trade locked. But yeah, they are... Well, we're going to get into it. So, over the past week, we've been discussing ways to address this situation, with the goal of minimizing the impact on the TF2 community as a whole, while preserving the experience of customers who had simply opened the crate, made a trade, or purchased from the market on the 25th, unaware a bug... Yeah, that's fair enough, you know? If, like, someone could have been completely out the loop and saw their Dream Unusual hat on the market for pretty cheap, didn't realize that it was going to get trade locked. I think that is fair enough. The people that didn't intentionally abuse a bug or didn't intentionally contribute towards a bug shouldn't be punished, and you know, good job, Valve. So during our investigation, we discovered that a small number of accounts acquired these hats, and an even smaller portion of these accounts acquired an exceedingly large number of them. Based on this, we've decided that if you had currently owned one of these unusual hats, the first one added to your account will be made tradable. Wait, does that make sense? We've decided that if you currently own one of those unusual hats, the first one added to your account will be made tradable. Any other unusual you have received due to the bug will remain permanently trade locked. If you decide that you would rather not have these trade locked hats on your account, you may instead elect a full refund on any number of item. The number of unusual items being made tradable represents about 1 month of the regular unusual drop rate. So the impact it's going to have on the economy isn't too large, and I think this segment right here is them specifying that they're really not like ruining the economy with this. It's literally just like sped the economy up by a month, depending on how you look at it. So I think it's very good that they stated this, because a lot of people don't really know the numbers or don't have a rough idea of how many of these hats will be in circulation now, and it's just an extra month's worth. So a few of you were concerned you had done nothing wrong by opening a bugged crate and proceeded to delete your hats. While we appreciate the concern, you didn't do anything wrong. So hats from the bugged crates deleted before the tradable date will be restored to your accounts with the same restrictions described above. So if you deleted your unusual because you thought Valve would ban you, or you deleted it because you didn't own a glitched unusual, you can get it back. That's massive. That's huge from Valve, literally. That is insane. I never really anticipated this. I know a lot of people who opened a lot of these crates did delete them because they felt guilty for owning these glitched unusuals, and Valve was saying, you know what, take them back. Item tradability, restoration, and the refund support page will be made available in about a week's time. We'll post another update when the exact date becomes available. We apologize for the inconvenience of this incident, and we've added safeguards to prevent incidents like this in the future. Now, I've got a few things to say about this. First of all, respect to Valve, you know, they've listened to the community, it seems like. A lot of people are saying it looks like they've listened to the community here. There are a few issues I have, though. A lot of people hypothesize they'd get a cheater's lament for not partaking in the event. And whilst I think that's unrealistic, this literally means that if you didn't partake in the glitch, you get nothing. You don't get an untradeable cheater's lament or anything. You literally get nothing. And people are going to feel hard done by, but at the same time, it's a really tricky one, and I do feel like a lot of the people who didn't abuse this bug are going to feel very hard done by and upset by this. Also, I don't know if the items are going to be made marketable. It says, as you can see here, the number of unusuals being made tradable represents about 1 month of the regular unusual drop rate. And while that's pretty good, are they going to be marketable as well? Is this going to have a big impact on the Steam market, on the prices of unusuals as a whole? We just don't know. And that is, it's that uncertainty again. Like, I guess it's just lack of description, I suppose, but this is a pretty good solution. I just don't understand why they're making one of them tradable. I get the fact that people may have bought these things and wanted to have it tradable and didn't know about the glitch, but at the same time, they got a good unusual for really cheap, I assume. So, I don't know, it's just trying to please everyone. I think it's good as well they included this bit, including the number as well, because now people are going to have a rough idea of just how this is going to impact the economy. Now, there is a kind of thing that, even though it's only the first unusual you got, I mean, let me show you guys. This is my unusuals, my backpack. The first unusual I got is a Scorching Flames Big Elfin deal, which is like 25 or 30 keys. It's still marked with the not tradable stuff. However, I unboxed this, which was like 125 keys. I will not be able to sell this one. And it kind of sucks because this is worth a lot more and I don't get to pick which one to trade. And as much as I'd like that, I think that is the best way to do this so people can't like abuse the system and have a burning KE tradable, even though it's like the 10th they unboxed or something. I don't know. It's a pretty good response from Valve. I just think that there was no real reason to make them tradable apart from the fact that the fact that they've made only one tradable, it kind of gives back to the people who didn't abuse the bug in a way. If you just purchased an unusual or you only unboxed one just to see if it was like, you know, an official thing, then you get that tradable. Is this going to impact the economy? Yes, there's no escaping that. They've essentially added a month's worth of unusual drops between everyone into the game at the same time. Even though a lot of them are going to be like lower tier ones, it's still going to have a big impact on the economy, I think. But it's a lot less damage than what they could have done. It's a lot less than what they could have done. So as a whole, I'm just kind of looking at how everyone's responding to this. A lot of people are saying this is like the perfect response from Valve. And yeah, I mean, it kind of caters towards everyone, you know. The people who unintentionally contributed, the people who contributed not for self-gain, it kind of contributes to everyone, and it doesn't ruin the economy. It's going to have an impact on the economy. It's not going to ruin the economy. And I think that is like the main thing that a lot of people are worried about. If they make them all tradable, then the economy is going to crash. If they make them all untradable, there'll be no impact at all. And it seems like they've found a good middle ground that kind of pleases everyone. And that's what I like about this. Like, look at some of the stuff people are saying on Reddit right now. So, like, there's a few people who are obviously upset, but a lot of people are just saying, like, thank you, Valve, for saying this. All the traders who insisted people would just open crates for some are breaking the rules. Yeah, I mean, a lot of people hypothesize the fact that people would get banned, and it's good that Valve have actually acknowledged that, like, you didn't do anything wrong. You know, they're fully holding their hands up and saying, we made the mistake here, we can't punish the people who opened a crate. Because that's the bottom line, you know, and it's a very mature response from Valve to not only, like, try and please everyone, but also to, as I said, kind of take responsibility. I think this is, like, a really good response, and it's really nice to see this level of communication. They're even catering towards the people who deleted the hats as well, which I just think is fantastic, you know? So this is it. This is the Crate Depression, as referred to by Team Fortress 2, the Team Fortress 2 team themselves. The Crate Depression has now been sold. It's going to be really interesting to see the approach they take in restoring the deleted items. I wonder if you're going to have to send in a ticket or anything like that, or if you're going to have to kind of like write off to Steam support or anything, or if they'll just kind of like add it back to your account. It's going to be really up in the air to see how they handled this. But honestly, I'm really proud, I want to say. I'm really proud of the TF2 team for responding this fast and catering to everyone, you know? By making the first one tradable, they're catering to pretty much everyone. That's a solution I didn't see once. I watched pretty much every TF2 YouTuber who made a video on this video, and not one of them suggested that they make one unusual tradable to kind of cater towards the person that bought their dream unusual and stuff like that, or perhaps cater to someone who unboxed one crate, got something amazing, didn't unbox anymore. They're really catering towards that, and the only person they're not catering to, so to speak, is the people who unboxed a crate or didn't unbox a crate because they didn't want to abuse a bug. And that's kind of like, you know, that's just the cold hard truth of it, is that if you didn't want to abuse a bug, you're not going to get anything. And I mean, I'm sure the people are going to be okay with that, because they'll probably be able to pick up an unusual for slightly cheaper anyway once these things get made tradable. But guys, that is just going to be about it for this video. What do you guys think about Valve's response? Do you think this is the best possible solution they could have had? Would you have changed anything if you were doing it? Let me know down in the comments below. I think it's a really interesting discussion point to talk about if they could have changed anything, perhaps your ideal response. But honestly, I think this is pleasing the majority. And I think Valve have done a fantastic job on that. And the fact they're just kind of like settling everyone down by specifying the numbers and stuff like that is just great to me. So, guys, that is just about it for this video. If you did enjoy, please do remember to leave a like and let me know your thoughts down below. If you'd like to see more videos like this and general gaming content, do be sure to subscribe. Thanks again so much for watching, guys, and peace. The type of guy to see it empty when there's half a glass. See the worst in everything to find good, need an actual map. Now I'm stuck up in my head just like it's Alcatraz. And there's no escaping cause I don't know where the key's planted at. Spit for hours, got the stamina. See clear, don't need a camera. I know exactly what these dons will say cause I've examined ya. I've broken.